Hello guys! Today I will talk again about the authentication, but now I will handle the HTTP session in the controllers and how to serialize it into Redis. Just click on the subscribe button to support my work and let's go! Having the session in the controllers allows me to store more information about the requests, but this also means that the requests have a state, that I'm in a stateful application. Nowadays, we used to fear the HTTP session, because it's a meaning of a stateful application. But how many have a perfect application? I don't have a perfect application. When starting the communication with the Spring Boot application, I can specify that a session can be created. This will return me a cookie to identify the session. In this cookie, I can store whatever information I want, which will help the application register all the transactions previously done by the user. This way, the application already knows the user, not only by its credentials, but also by its previous actions. Consequently, the information sent on each request can be slightly lower. I don't need to indicate all the history of the transaction made by the user to reproduce an action. This information is already stored in the session. This is very useful when I build a basket. I can add items of the user in its basket without finalizing the sale. The information about the added items will remain on the session until the user finishes the transaction. On the other side, without the session, I need to store somewhere all the items the user added to the basket. It can be in the database or maintaining all this information on each request. Of course, there are some inconveniences, but let's see first how to create a session for each request. I start with a similar code as done in the video of authenticating via the cookie. And this is the needed line to create a session at each request. That's all, and now add the session in the controllers to store the needed information. This way, the frontend doesn't need to know which page the user wants to read. The frontend only needs to know that the user wants to load the next page. The Spring Boot application already knows which page was loaded. Let's see how it works. Here is the cookie created by my Spring Boot application. Let's use it now. Here I get my message, and I can use my created parameter. But here comes the hidden phase of a stateful application. What happens if for some reason my application restarts? Now I run again my previous request and I've got an authentication error because the information about the session was removed with the application restart. How to solve this? Serializing the session and storing it somewhere. Where? In Redis. Why? Redis is a key value storage service, and it is known to be very performant to get the value from a single key. In my case, I have the ID of the session. This can be the key, and the session itself can be the value. So I have to make my user information serializable to be stored in Redis. and I have to tell Spring Boot where to save the session. For that, I need two dependencies. One to tell Spring Boot about the connection with Redis, and the other to tell how to serialize the user information of the session into Redis. Now configure my user information, my user object to be serializable. Implementing this interface, Java knows that this object can be serializable, can be formatted into a string. And finally, configure Spring Boot with the connection to Redis. This is to indicate where to store the session, in Redis. Let's start all of this again. I first log in to get my session ID. Now I use my cookie to make a request, and now restart my application and see if the cookie is still valid. And run again my previous request. I still have my user connected with the same cookie. Let's take a quick look at Redis. Here I get my session information. And here is the key of the stored information in my session and its value, which is encoded as it is an object. Conclusion: to have the benefits of a stateless application but maintain the user session, I need the user object to be serializable, a place to store the user object, in this case Redis. Add the two dependencies to serialize the user object to Redis and to connect my application to Redis. And finally, add the connection information to Redis into my configuration file. This way, having the user session serialized into Redis, I can have the benefits of a stateless application, as the redundant servers, the fail-safe application, etc. I hope you liked the video. I would appreciate if you click on the thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. And see you in the next video. Bye!